The boy with a broken brain was a phrase once used to describe one of the foremost experts on learning and brain development today. Jim Quick grew up with a learning disability when young, but has shown through his life precisely how a growth mindset can benefit you to achieve massive success today. Here, I want to present you with precisely how and why a growth mindset can be hugely beneficial in your life, using the example of Jim Quick and some of the ideas he talks about to help you in your learning. Often, mindsets are categorized as either being fixed or growth, with fixed generally being one which holds the belief that qualities and traits are fixed and therefore cannot change. In truth, I've been guilty of this myself at times, as I don't think I'm capable of something purely based on past experiences or doubts about myself. A growth mindset, on the other hand, is one where you believe that through dedication and work, you can improve your most basic traits and abilities, even holding the belief that you can become more intelligent. This is the mindset I have today, and honestly, I can't say how much I feel it's benefited me. Beyond tangible results I can point to as a consequence of having a growth mindset, it's equally helped my mental health and confidence. In a growth mindset, the key component is that someone's perspective on failure is shifted, because they no longer see failure as an endpoint, but rather as a part of the process to reaching their eventual goal. Dr. Carol Dweck of Stanford University, and one of the foremost experts on having a growth mindset, says that kids taught to learn with a growth mindset have been taught to focus primarily on the process of reaching their desired outcome, rather than the outcome itself. Often with teachers encouraging children more when they've had to go through the process to achieve a result, rather than achieving the result immediately. The whole point here is that it's been found that when people are encouraged that they can do more than they might believe, they have shown that they will commit to putting extra time and effort needed to eventually reach that goal. So, what about the science behind this? Well, the general principles come from the idea of neuroplasticity, or the principal idea of brain growth. Think of the brain like a muscle. In order to grow a muscle, we need to work it, and the same is true of the brain. As we're challenged, what happens is that we build neuronal connections in the brain, helping us to think faster and more efficiently, as well as growing skills and building habits. Therefore, through this process of working the brain, you see neuroplasticity take effect and you effectively become smarter. This is the point of a growth mindset. It's focused on that process of growing the brain by challenging it. The results that come from that process are just the natural output. In the motivation field, you'll often hear buzzwords like you need to work through the pain, persevere, work hard, and focus on your dreams and goals. Sure enough, these give us a nice dopamine kick to make us feel good, but the reason these talks often resonate with us is because behind the message there's actually something of distinct value, something we know that holds truth in it. Now, just quickly, if you're enjoying the video, please do leave a like. This doesn't just serve to help me know it's benefiting you, but hopefully will help the algorithm push it out to others who may also benefit too. So, going back to Jim Quick, what process can we learn from him to help us develop and use our growth mindset? Well, let's look at the FAST method, not only named this way because it's designed to help you learn faster, but serves to be an acronym for the methodology, starting with FORGET. To confirm, forget doesn't specifically mean to try and forget something you've learned on a particular subject, but rather to forget any preconceptions you might have on that subject. This is because often when we feel that we have some knowledge on a subject that we're learning, it can naturally lead us to pay less attention when learning more about it. The whole idea is to aim to have an open mind when learning, which helps us to be more active learners. The next letter in the FAST model is to be active in our learning, which might be as simple as taking notes or asking questions, and if possible, when learning a skill, actively practicing that skill. For example, for someone who writes software code, to write code when learning a new language is often a necessity. Just as with spoken language, active practice is necessary to correctly communicate on a daily basis. However, to do this, you need to set your state. Those who follow Tony Robbins will know this, but your state will often determine how well you do something. And the more you can control your state and identify positive emotions with the learning process, the more likely you'll be to commit what you learn to your long-term memory. This might be as simple as changing your posture, controlling your breathing, or understanding why you'll benefit from what you learn. Which leads us to the last letter of the FAST model, to teach. Richard Feynman taught that the final process of learning something new is to transmit it to others, and the FAST method is the same, As if you actively learn something that you know you need to teach to someone else, you're more likely to pay attention. That's exactly what I'm doing in this video. I'm working through the FAST method so I can teach you about it in a succinct way. Not only does that hopefully benefit you, but as a result, I better learn the material myself. After all, as Jim says,
because when you teach something, you get to learn it twice.